It's not a good time, Wendy.
Dad's dead.
What? How's mom?
She's mom, you know? She asked me how much to tip the nurses.
Your father had one final request, and we are gonna honor it. He just wanted his kids under one roof. So for the next 7 days, you are all grounded.
To clarify, today does count as one of the seven, right?
I actually started out really wanting to tell a story about a man who discovers kind of later than he should have that his life was all wrong.
What happened to Quinn? You guys didn't split up, did you?
She slept with my boss.
Well, that'll do it.
Yes, it did.
Done.
Right.
I just found when I was writing the book that the only time the book really came alive for me is when he was interacting with his siblings and his mother.
Whoops, we come apart there. Mom, close that robe.
It's just breasts, John. Same ones you suckled at.
No, mother, those are not the same breasts you nursed us with. You got bionic breasts now.
And I really wanted to, you know, tell a story about how your family will save you, whether you like it or not.
I knew as soon as I read this book that this was a movie I needed to make.
Jonathan is not only a novelist, he is a screenwriter, so he understands the leaps that you have to make.
He did a great job on the script and really got it to the point where the actors wanted to do it.
This is the guy that slept with my wife.
Who are you coming in here with this middle part at your age?
I'm Wendy Altman, bitch! Yeah, that's a princess cut!
I thought that the script was great. And my reaction was that it's the whole package, and I would love to be a part of it.
We made love on our first date.
Mom.
I don't mind telling you, the man was hung.
That should have been the headstone.
Clearly, she lost more than a husband.
I've always been a big movie fan, and I look at movies as a very different animal than books, so it was really not hard for me to take apart my own book and find the movie inside of it.
Not that they fight like girls. More like very effeminate kittens.
I'm really glad that he did it, because he kept the feeling of the novel that a lot of people like a lot.
Starting over is complicated. And you don't do complicated, Judd. You never have.
Oh, no, no! Oh.
You're not catching me at my best. I'm not trying
to stop. For people who are fans of the book, I think they'll be very satisfied in how true it is. But I think if you have not read the book, you will still be fully engaged in the story.
The movie has some genuinely big laughs and a lot of them.
You need to put a baby in that woman, like yesterday. Have you had your man parts checked? Since you may have emptied them over the years. My room is next to yours. My room is next to yours.
But I think it's also something more. I think it's something resonant and touching.
My hope is that people will walk out of the theater having been moved, but smiling.
You guys are idiots, but you're my idiots.
Baby monitor on upstairs.
Oh, there we go. There.
Turn it off.
Turn it up.
Oh,
turn it up.
Stick a baby in there, Paul. Shove a baby up there.
It's a circle of life, everybody. Let's go, Altmans. I'm just trying to get home.